The summit will give emphasis to the policy direction of the Duterte administration that the maritime interest of the Philippines rests on sustainable development and safeguarding our national patrimony, marine wealth, and national territory. On the part of the Office of the National Security Advisor and the officials with me today, the National Marine Summit is our vehicle to push for the following. One, becoming a more responsible stakeholder for the environment. The Philippines already had a solid record and reputation for marine environment conservation and protection. We will step up our efforts here because the East Asian seas are connected. We will explore the possibility of connecting our marine protected areas with neighboring countries, especially within the Coral Triangle and the rest of the region. Two, pursue our robust marine scientific research. We are already building our capabilities for marine scientific research by acquiring state-of-the-art research and survey vessels. MSR is the first step for the sustainable development of the marine resources, which will benefit both Filipinos and the rest of mankind. So we will build the National Academic Research Fleet, and we will lift shortly the moratorium on marine scientific research by foreign government and institutions. Three, we will invest on credible defense posture and maritime law enforcement capability. And based on studies and as practiced in some parts of the world, spending about 2% of the gross domestic product for national defense would be sufficient. We shall invest towards a credible defense posture and maritime law enforcement capability.
Sir, you mentioned about the lifting of moratorium on research, maritime research. Why and which countries are we opening our?
We are lifting maritime scientific research is good for us and for other research institutions simply because we get to know more of the maritime domain. We suspended it sometime in 2018 because of some institutions and entities that would come in without even our permission. So the president pronounced that it's henceforth it shall be stopped, and thus the moratorium. There were also cases where some applicants would claim that we have denied their permits, but the truth was they were not willing to allow Filipino scientists to board the scientific research vessels. That was if we don't allow us, then what benefit do we get out of it? Since they are supposed to deposit with us the materials and the findings as well as the materials. So we are opening up again the MSR processing permits for MSR simply because we believe that the academe have to be deployed and do research for us and for all of mankind to get to know more about our maritime domain. So MSI, for one, has been allowed to purchase one research vessel. It's one of our new additions, the UP Marine Scientific Marine Science Institute. We are trying to get more, another one for the National Institute for Geological Sciences, and we are trying to get a bigger one for the Department of Environment, Department of Energy.
Sir, will there be agreements entered by the Philippine government with countries such as China and Russia regarding this research?
No, MSRs are open to, scientific research is open to all institutions and countries, and by provisions of the UNCLOS, they simply have to seek the permission of the host littoral country. No need for agreements. We simply have to base our agreements on the MSR vessels that would come here to our maritime domain.